how can we rekindle our sense of common humanity? This unfortunate timeless quandary is the foundation of Ubuntu, and the question that was posed to the more than 20 non-Western artists presented by the Palais de Tokyo.
Actually, artists aren't here to bring us answers. They're here to help us think about the world differently, to open up our imaginations to other ways of thinking, like Ubuntu, which could maybe help us imagine a different future.
Nolan Oswald Dennis is one of those people who likes pushing boundaries, tracing them with his own footsteps, and in the process, appropriate and reinvent a space that's been rocked by colonization.
It's a map of places that exist but don't exist at the same time. Dreams, fantasies, political mythologies. It's a map of Africa that doesn't exist yet. And it's painted on the floor. It invites you to walk, to be a part of it. And the more people walk across it, the more it changes.
With Ubuntu, we can also reimagine the role of women in society. Through the works of Colombian artist Daniel Otero Torres, depictions of Amazon warriors of all stripes who were ignored in a history written and told by men. A choice also made by Turia Magadlela when she asks of visitors to walk into this tent made of hundreds of women's tights, each and every piece telling an original story, but weaved together in a collective female history of humanity.
Every single woman in our continent should be represented somehow. If you look at the finer details of the work, sometimes you see people's names, sometimes you see the company's names that made the paintings. So I don't take out any of that detail.
Every piece, every artist brings their own vision of Ubuntu, leading to an experience with an abundance of perspectives as diverse as humanity itself.